Well, it's the 4th of July weekend. You know what that means. There's gonna be some of this. And this.
Bagel tear? Would it revert, tear? Would it revert? Oh, Lord! Lord, Jesus! Oh, Lord! Oh, Jesus! What you doing, tear?
And even some of this. Typically for Independence Day, people celebrate their freedom. Now this freedom includes life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Now truly, God Almighty has given us the great gift of free will. And so freedom is not in and of itself a bad thing. It's only when we misuse and abuse our freedom that it becomes bad and negatively affects others. And the choices we make out from our free will have consequences that will affect others, whether in the short term or in the long term. Well, since we're on the fireworks themes here, here's an example of how someone's freedom became chaos for others. Listen, sometimes the consequences of our choices start small fires. But sometimes the consequences of our choices hurt people.
At least 17 people, including 10 LAPD officers and ATF agent in nearby residents, were injured when the blast happened about 7:30. LAPD had seized 5,000 pounds of legal fireworks.
But this video isn't about fireworks, it's about freedom. So I challenge you to ponder on two things for this 4th of July weekend. One, how are you using your freedom? And two, are you truly free? Or are you a slave and you don't even realize it? So one, how are you using your freedom? Look, 1 Corinthians 10, 23-24 says, "All things are lawful, but not all things are profitable. All things are lawful, but not all things edify. Let no one seek his own good, but that of his neighbor." So yes, you can do anything you want to do with your freedom, but just because you can do something doesn't mean you should. Galatians 5, 13-14 says, "For you are called to freedom, brethren, only do not turn your freedom into an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another. For the whole law is fulfilled in one word in the statement, 'You shall love your neighbor as yourself.'" So, how are you using your freedom? Are you loving others? Or are you walking by the flesh to selfishly serve yourself? 1 Corinthians 6:12 says, "All things are lawful for me, but not all things are profitable. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be mastered by anything." Now, which brings us to the second thing to ponder. Are you truly free? Or are you a slave and you don't even realize it? Two, are you truly free? Romans 6:16 says, "Do you not know that when you present yourselves to someone as slaves for obedience, you are slaves of the one whom you obey, either of sin resulting in death or of obedience resulting in righteousness?" In John 8:34, Jesus said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is the slave of sin." Now, in this life, we are all slaves to sin. The only way to freedom is through Christ Jesus. That which you cannot walk away from has ownership over you. If you are unable to release your hatred toward others and you can't forgive people, look, you are a slave to that sin. If you are incapable of walking away from drugs or alcohol, or pornography, you are a slave to those desires. Look, even if you're unable to walk away from something seemingly insignificant as a cigarette, you are a slave to the desire. Slavery does exist. However, the person in bondage usually enslaved him or herself. What have you allowed in your life that has enslaved you? What are you unable to walk away from? Are you truly free? Look, there's only one way to be free, and that's to put your faith in Christ's finished work on the cross, because he did what we were never able to do, save us from ourselves. We could never do that, no matter how hard we worked. Look, for this reason, it is written in John 8:36. So if the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed. And just a few verses earlier in John 8:31-32, Jesus said, if you continue in my word, then you are truly disciples of mine, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Now, what is truth? Pilate asked that. In John 14:6, Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. Listen, do you want to celebrate true freedom this Independence Day? Then confess Christ as Lord and Savior and invite the Holy Spirit to dwell within you, guiding you to walk in righteousness. This doesn't mean you can't have fun. It simply means we no longer selfishly serve ourselves by living in the flesh. Look, 2 Corinthians 3:17 says, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And how do we know that we're walking in true freedom? Because we will be walking by the Spirit, not the flesh. Galatians 5:16-25, it is written, but I say, walk by the Spirit, and you will not carry out the desire of the flesh, for the flesh sets its desire against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, for these are in opposition to one another, so that you may not do the things that you please. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now, the deeds of the flesh are evident, which are immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, outbursts of anger, disputes, dissensions, factions, envying, drunkenness, carousing, and things like these, of which I forewarn you, just as I have forewarned you, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things, there is no law. Now those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh and its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also walk by the Spirit. In Matthew 5:14-16, Jesus said, you are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor does anyone light a lamp and then put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. So if your choices have consequences and affect others, do as the Lord commands you, and you will bless others. Let your light shine so that they may see your good works. Now we've seen what choices look like when they negatively affect others. Let's examine what it looks like when our choices bless others. What are you waiting for? So what are you waiting for? Look, go out and have fun this 4th of July weekend, but make sure that you are the light in the darkness of this world. Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven.